Hey guys, here's a new video, and today I'm doing the Hot Toys Superman the Movie 12-inch figure, of course, of Superman, the Christopher Reeve version. The person I think of when someone says, Superman, that's who I think of. I know there was George Reeve, there was Dean Cain, Tom Welling, a few of those that I'm missing, but Christopher Reeve is the person I think of when someone brings up the name Superman. Now, just to give you an idea of how big the box is, that's my bookcase, you know, that's my little table here. If you have any Hot Toys boxes in your collection, you will have an idea of how big this is. And this is about double the length of your standard Hot Toys mailer. It's a little bit bigger. It's an overall big box. Now, the reason it is so big is when you take it away and open it up, first you will find this little piece here. Now, this may confuse you at first. It may be confusing. Don't let it worry you. You lay it down and open it up like that. That's what it's there for. Now, one thing I've noticed with this set, and I see this more than with their other Hot Toys figures, they've always had nice collector-friendly boxes that are just nice for display. I think they went a little out of their way to make this box extra collector-friendly, extra that you want to display this. Because this is the box itself. And I think I'm pulling off the little insert on the front. But there you go. Just a big honkin' display box. And I do like it. I do. It's just, I'm the kind of person that opens it up, plays with the figure, puts it on the shelf, poses it occasionally, while the box is away in storage somewhere. I'm not someone who has their boxes displayed with their figures. If I did, I would probably like this a whole lot more, but as it is, I'm really not all that thrilled with it. Put that aside. Put that away. When you open the box up, boom, 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 boom. There we go. This always falls out. This is your insert just showing who made it, who designed it, who sculpted what. Nothing all too special. What I do like, however, and I probably should leave this out so I can show it off a little better. That'd be smart. That'd be smart, yeah. You have on the front this really nice in memory of Christopher Reeve. It's something that they really didn't have to include, but I'm glad that it just kind of honors memory. Honestly, Superman would not be as big as he is, at least in the film world, if it wasn't for Christopher Reeve, in my opinion. But this little insert comes right out. Now, I've already taken everything out, but this box is just, I'm really unsure about it. You have all of this empty space, which, I don't know. I kind of wish they had just released your standard, you know, Hot Toys box about this big. Nothing too special. This one, you have his big stand goes behind him, the standard stand goes there, all the pieces for his base go all through there on the sides, his hands are there, and that's where the figure is. But you have all this empty space on the plastic, and it takes up a lot of space on a shelf, especially for someone who doesn't even really display this. You just put it away for storage, it takes up a lot of space, and I'm really kind of unsure. I know there's fans of that who love this box, who will think it's an excellent addition to their collection, but I'm kind of more of a, I like saving space with things, but it is nice that they included it. It does look good for display, I will admit that, but overall, I'm not too impressed with it. I'm going to get rid of that again. Now on to the figure himself. This glorious little guy here. He's spectacular. I'm pretty sure this guy, if you count my like custom figures, like the Tony Stark and the Nurse Joker, if you count those, and I'm not going to leave the camera like this, Don't worry. But this guy will make my 11th Hot Toys figure, if you count those custom third-party ones. And I think he may actually be my favorite, just by his overall look. I really do like this guy. And he does come with your standard Hot Toys stand, with Superman the Movie and his name on the front there. But he also comes with this pretty freaking crazy stand that's more for his flight pose. It's meant to be of the Fortress of Solitude. And that's just to give an idea of how big it is. It's a pretty big stand, and it does look nice with him. You can, of course, have him displayed flying on it, or, and I probably should have had the hook a little less tight, but you can actually have him standing on it, no problem as well. It's just, since I have the hook a little tighter than I should, I can't really use that at the moment. But there's that. I'm going to go ahead and scoot you over there, get back to our now usual position. That was just to give you an idea of just how big he is, how he looks. The figure itself really blew me away. Normally, I'm not a fan of this kind of mesh material that his costume's made of, this really kind of stretchy material. I think it was the DC Direct 12-inch Green Lantern that had it, the Hal Jordan with the different head sculpts and all that kind of stuff. I really didn't like how that costume went. I thought it was kind of gimmicky, kind of cheap, and it didn't really win me over. However, this one, considering that's how the costume was in the movie, I'm all for it. I think it looks great. If you are someone who likes to take apart their Hot Toys figures, I know there's a big thing, a big deal with auctions that have just the costumes, you may be kind of let down. He does come with a little manual here that basically says to rotate the head before turning it up and down because it could scrape the paint off. It shows you how to assemble his base. It has what numbers go where, which is that right there. It's not all too complicated. It's not rocket science, but it is there if you need it. But it does mention that his belt is not detachable. So you're stuck with that. As for the rest of the costume, the cape, it does have little snaps at the shoulders and the back here, but it's stitched into the color of his costume. And while there is a zipper, I think this top part is sewn onto his tights somewhere around here. So you really can't take his costume off and put it like on a Joker figure or something if that's really what you want to do. But what is really nice about this costume is that I always mention that, you know, this figure has the standard Hot Toys articulation. You can't really see that most of them because their costumes limit their movement. With this material, you can have him pose in any number of ways and not risk tearing the fabric. You're not limited by any kind of armor like the Iron Man stuff is, the Thor figure. There's no clothes to really limit anything. You can have all of your full movements. And this is actually my first Hot Toys figure. You can really see how bendable and how poseable they are. There's just so much movement that you can do with these guys. And it's kind of sad that a lot of the time they're limited from their clothes. This is the first figure that I have that you can actually move them and get a full degree of movement. And I like it. I think it looks great. Look at him. He's proud of his muscles. He's just, ooh. Now onto the face sculpt. It does seem that I can't really show it off all too well, which is how my lighting is. But I'm going to try. Going to try my best to show it off. This is, without a doubt, Christopher Reeve. And I should not have done that little lock thing. That's not good. But that is, without a doubt, Christopher Reeve. And that is just an excellent face sculpt. I really do like it. Even just his blue eyes. That is, without a doubt, Christopher Reeve. And it looks great. It's a great looking figure. The S-shield on the front is fantastic. The cape is great. The cape, I was kind of worried with it being all wrinkled it up, but what is cool thing I didn't really notice until take three of this is that there's a little wire that goes along the edge here, so you can actually pose the cape how you want. It's not like an excellent degree of posing. You can't get like some really super, let's get him standing there, super degrees of movement, but it does have this little wire so you can get it straightened out, and it should over time return to its normal shape. It is flexible as well, and it's just an iconic piece of his costume, and it just looks great. The articulation, the only thing that's really hindered is his ankle movements by his boots, but they are kind of rubbery, so you do get some movement with them as well. It's just, this is a great figure. I am overwhelmed with how great this looks in person. Now, for his stand, you can, of course, use the standard crotch grabber if you really want to. I'm probably not going to do it. The crotch grabber is nice for saving space, but for something like this, you got to have this guy. For these pieces, they just fit into their own little slots. They fit in basically by friction only. To give an idea, let's go down to there. You can see they just go in and out, no problem. They're held in strictly by friction. And some of them are easier to go in than others. Just kind of use a little force if needed. And then when that's done, take your little peg here, peg it in place. Get a small Phillips screwdriver to loosen up the screw so you can put the clamp on there. I actually probably have it a little tighter than I should. I'm going to just adjust that real quick so I can actually move this around. There we go. That's a little better. Now with that being able to move, I can have him, you know, probably going to ruin it with a cape. But anyway, you can get that out of the way and have him just standing on his base like that, just in the fortress, if you so desire. There's a nice little spot for his feet to stand. But if you are buying this, you probably want to have him flying. Just get your little clamp up top. The screw may be too loose, but we'll see. And there you go. He's in there. Posing-wise, I'm a terrible person when it comes to posing. I am not good at it. So we'll just kind of do something kind of like that and just hope for the best. Just to give you an idea of just how he looks up there. I am terrible when it comes to posing. Absolutely horrible. That's just how he looks on the stand. I think it looks great. And It's a nice thing to do. You can actually have him posing in flight. I would like if you could have him kind of more in his, like, outreach flying pose somehow, but I don't think they really do that realistically. You can, of course, have him displayed with his arms straight out, if you so desire. I think it's kind of more like that. For his hands, you can see he does come with the two little fists. He also comes with two hands that are open, like that. And then two hands that are kind of more for his flying pose. So I think, you know, let's just toy with that real quick. So there's the little peg that just fits right in there. Then peg that into his arm there. It fits in surprisingly easy. You can kind of, you know, even like a little wave. He's waving to you. Hi, thanks for watching my movie, guys. Thank you. No, it's just, it's nice they included it. If you do have any issues with his wrist pegs, there are two additional ones included, kind of with your standard Hot Toys kind of thing. They normally include additional wrist pegs in case you, he's so happy to see you. Oh, look at him. He's just, hi. He's happy. I really do like this guy. My only real complaint with this costume is there's no real way to attach these to his wrists. They constantly get pulled up and it's a minor nitpick. It really is. I do wish he had came with a little bit more. I know if you get the Sideshow exclusive version, if you buy this guy through Big Bad Toys or Entertainment Earth, any of those places, you get this figure. You get just the Hot Toy Superman. That's it, which is not a bad thing. If you buy this through Sideshow directly, you get an additional piece that is exclusive to them. It's a little metal chain with the kryptonite rock that he wore in the first movie that Lex Luthor put on him. I really didn't have a need for that. That's something that if I had, it would just go away in a box somewhere. I wouldn't ever really display it. So if you do want that little piece of accessory, go with Sideshow. They do have it. If you just want the figure, Big Bad Toy Store is my pick. That's where I got mine. And I cannot recommend this guy anymore. He may be my favorite Hot Toys figure, and I'm glad to have him in my collection. So, I'm sorry if you couldn't see anything from this new layout. I know Hot Toys figures will probably be the hardest to film like this. But I think I did okay. Maybe. I don't know. We'll see. But I hope you guys have a great day, and I will see you around. Thanks for watching, like always, and take care.